Let me just move over to Tom Hanks. We can't keep you away from London, Tom. You know, you were here for the beginning, you're here for the closing. I think that's a record. Was there...
I've been sleeping in a sleeping bag behind a tea shop by the Serpentine in Hyde Park for the last week and a half. The rain almost killed me.
He rehearsed that joke 5 minutes ago.
It is Serpentine.
It worked really well then.
Thank God. Thank God. I'm sorry, I interrupted your fascinating question.
No. Was there... Was there any sense of trepidation for you in playing someone like Walt Disney?
Trepidation's an
interesting word. Does he seem to you like the kind of man that would experience trepidation in approaching a role? Sorry, I didn't mean... Was that for me or for Tom?
Believe me. Hey, you got to act with a horse.
Me.
I don't know what that meant exactly. No,
you're referencing darling. Me, I don't know.
My lovely wife, Ruth Wilson, by the way. I'm not trying to dodge the question. I swear to God, I'm not. There was a responsibility, let me put it that way, which is different than trepidation. It's without a doubt, it's a substantial gauntlet to throw down. I grew up, Walt Disney was ubiquitous in our lives as Uncle Sam and Smokey the Bear and the combination of the President of the United States and Mickey Mouse himself. So I felt as though there was going to be quite a distance to go, and I had not a clue as to where to begin outside my own memories, and that led to a substantial amount. There's a lot of video out there. There's a lot of audio that you can listen to. Unfortunately, it's mostly Walt Disney performing as Walt Disney. So when you could find those moments where it was just talking in its natural cadence about something other than the new exciting realm of Tomorrowland, which will be opening at Disney, that was worth its weight in gold. And I had some access to that thanks to Diane Miller Disney, his daughter, and the fabulous museum that she has established in San Francisco. But in this case, I was a hired gun. I didn't say anything that didn't appear in the script, and we had meetings in which we went over. I did have questions like there were some Americanisms that I think needed to be put in, and some things that I discovered that Walt had a tendency to say and imagery that he used, but that was all okayed. We treated this, I think we could all agree, like the Gutenberg Bible. We were not about to mess around with the work of the...
Yeah, we rolled a lot of joints with it.
Gospel according to. There are types of films that define themselves, and that was, I think, always going to be the requirement for making this movie. It was an extremely well-constructed, beautifully knit sweater, and I wasn't about to start pulling a thread loose and have it all fall apart. I had no dreams at all. I was just trying to, make you took a, I was just trying to get some other job other than the one I had. That's not unlike what Walt Disney did. When he started drawing, he was drawing out in the disconnected garage from his house in Kansas City, and he just had the art supplies, and he was just banging out stuff that came into his head, hoping that he might be able to sell them for $5 a piece. I relate to that. There's no clue as to where any of this stuff will take you. I was hoping to, make a little bit more than nothing, because I thought that this is just a job that you volunteer for, and if you're good enough at it, they'll ask you to play something else, and maybe they'll pay you $50 a week. But this concept of having dreams when you're young and always having your eye on the dream, I could never understand that. I didn't have a single dream in my head. I kind of operated like the communists, I had if I build a decent tractor, maybe I can build another tractor. It's like I didn't even have a 5-year plan. I was just stumbling around.
Tom Hanks, a communist.
Was Hanks communist? Thank you very much.
Was that the same for you?
Gentlemen back there.